Oh, yes!
The desert is a cruel place to fight.
Is there no
By all that's holy, you fight.
My victory is at hand! The desert will run with blood.
Hello everyone, Cedric here with another match from the Stronghold Crusader, the Sultan Tournament. I'm here with Nightmare, hello.
Hello.
So today Mali and Dan Zero are gonna fight again. We're gonna start the match. 3, 2, 1, go. On the top right corner there is Mali with the blue color, and on the bottom left corner there is Dan Zero. These two guys fought again in a previous round.
Your popularity is
they
falling.
Fought against each other and Dan Zero won. Okay, but the rules were different back then, and so was the map. And well, basically the players were not allowed to use mercenary units, they were only allowed to use European units, and the catapults were not allowed to shoot at units. They could only be used to shoot at how are they called, walls, towers and gates. That's it. And in this round, round 6, they are fighting with no fire, no flying stones rules, and on this 1v1 map. The map is created by expert players, as you can see. Everybody has an equal amount of everything. Nobody has more, nobody has less. Maybe they have more trees around here.
No, they don't. It's all the same. And even but a little bunch of trees doesn't really make an expert lose a game, you know?
It does. It does.
No, it doesn't.
So we can see that both players are building inns and breweries in order to increase their popularity. Mali already started producing shields. So will Dan Zero do very soon? We will see. Also, we can see that the players are not using a Bradico, they're using a Pulse. It's
that's a pity.
Is it a pity?
Yeah, I like Brad economies.
Yeah, but the Apple economy is faster and cheaper in wood.
It doesn't really matter. Brad economy is stronger in a longer game. Since most experts don't want to take the risk of making a bread economy, since it can kill a lot of population if you do it wrong, so people always play safe and go for apples.
I see. They should train more. We see that Mali built walls already. Let's see. Oh, okay, Dan Zero did the same. They're gonna build two gates, one on the side of the castle and one all in the front of the castle. It's gonna be an interesting match, hopefully not a short one. I want this to be a long match like the previous one that they had when they first met, and hopefully it's gonna be very interesting. So yeah, both players are building a lot of woodcutters. I can feel some lag.
Yeah, Mali is lagging, his ping is very high.
What is he doing?
Saving.
Okay. We can see that both players can build only two stone quarries and two iron mines, as you can see. Yeah, very interesting. They both... No, Mali does not have a hope farm. Dan Zero does. This way he... He basically keeps his ale production constant. Okay, the players are getting a lot of wood, and it is indicated for them to build mills instead of water pots, since they are gonna get tons of wood. Making mills is gonna be cheaper than making water pots. Water pots cost gold. While mills are not costing any gold, and they are actually making use of the resources. So yeah. Oh, is is Danzero gonna go for a bread economy? I can see he built a mill and several bakeries.
No. That's an expert style, you know, because we always sell food for workshops. So we, in the 3000 gold, you always start with like 25 wheat and we turn it into flour and then we turn it into bread so we can sell that.
What? Everything for the money, I see. We cherish every bit, every coin, every single coin. I don't want to lose it.
Yep.
A bit much, these taxes. Oh, okay, the players are getting tons of wood. That's just crazy. Just look at that.
Poppin' Jay!
Danzero almost finished all the trees and he's building more woodcutters. Mali still has wood. Still has trees around. Mali has a high ping.
Yeah. I'm feeling it too. I don't know why. Normally doesn't lag. Strange.
Normally. It's a different thing. Yeah, and I can expect a very big lag when the no rush time is over because both players are gonna make lots of troops. We can see that. Danzero's lord is a bit away from the keep. Maybe he's gonna surround it with walls. We can see that Mali is building several Fletcher workshops. He's gonna produce crossbows and sell them. You can get a very good price on crossbows. And so he's doing Danzero. He also has some how is it called?
Politurners
workshops, and he's producing pikes or
pikes. He's producing pikes.
You get a better price for pikes.
Nah, he probably doesn't want to sell them. He's going to make pikemen.
Oh, okay, interesting. So does Mali. We can see that Mali is building politurn workshops and several berries. Interesting. I guess he's buying hops, isn't it?
He's buying ale for the inns to work.
Yeah, but he bought hops this time. And he built berries.
I don't think he bought hops, or did he? He didn't use the hops in the start.
Oh.
I don't think he bought hops.
Yeah, that makes sense. Okay, we can see that their economy is quite equal, let's say equal. Danzero forgot to build the gates.
Nah, he didn't forget it. He just makes it after the no rush is over.
Yeah, and Danzero does not have anti-assassin walls like Mali does. So yeah.
It's gonna have a long way to go. And the no rush is still not over, so if I'm correctly, Danzero should make one. If not, he's not really playing it safe. Because Mali can be a fierce sneaker. Very big one.
Oh. We see that Danzero built a gate. And he should start building the second one.
Oh, Mali built stables.
Ooh.
Next to your keep, where Danzero can't see them.
Oh, yeah. Oh yeah, he is so such a sneaky bastard. Okay. I wonder if the players built walls. Oh, both. No, Danzero turned to sleep, and so did Mali. They turned to sleep their woodcutters in order to get a population.
Oh,
they're gonna make a lot of troops. Okay. Oh yes, Danzero is making anti-assassin's walls. He doesn't have stone though.
I can buy it.
Yeah, he's gonna protect this side easily. You can see that the no rush time is over. Both players, they don't have much units. Oh, we can see Mali sending assassins to Oh yeah, he already reached the gate with assassin, with one assassin. Very fast, very fast. Does Danzero have any assassins?
Nope. Don't see any assassins.
Okay, it's gonna be interesting. I think he's gonna snake his economy.
Nah, he can't get in with the anti-assassins. Well, he's just going to block off the gatehouse. It's a very annoying Stronghold Crusader physic, you know, when you open the gate and you go out and like an assassin is placed somewhere in that area, it just closes the gatehouse, which is really annoying for a lot of experts. And as you can see, his Mali's assassins are currently killing all the slaves that are coming by the gate.
Yeah, I saw that. Both players are digging in the moats. Both players surrounded their lord with walls. Assassins cannot touch them. Danzero is building a lot of portable shields. And Mali does not seem to have... Yep, it's okay, he's making engineers right now. I think he was busy with those assassins.
Nah, I think he just waited, you know, because if we make engineers, we will get less gold from taxes. And if we just wait a bit with making engineers, we get a lot more from taxes.
Alright, so it's basically he wanted to get a bit more gold.
Yeah, I was currently stalling Danzero, you could call it, by destroying his woodcutters and distracting him with the gatehouses.
Okay, we see that Mali is building a lot of shields fast, and Danzero already finished his portable shields. That's quite nice. We can see that the gates are blocked by assassins, except this one. This one was not blocked.
He opened it.
Yeah, he opened it.
Yeah,
he killed the assassins. Okay, good. Good. Very interesting, guys. Very interesting. This match is longer than I expected so far.
Yeah, it's faster than Lean against Myron. Longer, sorry.
Longer, yeah. We see that Mali made Knight. He's gonna use the knights to crush the horse archers.
Isn't and a lot of horse archers too.
Okay, let's check the armies. Mali has a bigger army. And Danzero is, getting from behind. He's making troops as well. He's making a pikeman. Okay, so basically pikeman should do good against...
Yeah, Mali got pikes too. Oh, he destroyed his gate. What are his horse archers doing? They're walking very strange.
Yeah. What's gonna happen? Okay, Danzero has knights as well. What is he gonna do? Okay, this is gonna be a long map, I suppose. Knightman, what do you think?
No, I don't know. It seems like Mali can end it pretty quick.
Oh. Oh yeah, he has. Okay, Danzero didn't let his knights fight Mali's knights just because he didn't want to lose all his units. But look, Danzero managed to deal quite some damage against Mali's units. You can see that Mali lost pretty much a lot of units in that battle. Oh yeah, it's gonna get interesting. So basically Mali's going back. He's going back to his keep. He should close the gate right now.
Oh, it got taken over.
Mali. Okay, Danzero is clearly doing better than Mali right now. Mali is doing more knights. Mali is building more knights, and I think Danzero can use those knights. Or they can do something. Oh, he's not going after the lord. He knows that he has no chance. Though, look, Mali is sending some pikemen to harass the horse archers that are belonging to Danzero. And Danzero is bringing down the walls. So yeah, basically Mali is in trouble. Let's see how Mali is gonna resist this. So basically Mali was one of the favorites in this tournament, and he seems to do quite bad.
No, I don't think so. I think Mali is doing better than Denzero at the moment.
Why?
Because Mali's economy is still working, Denzero's economy is dead, he doesn't have wood, his insert not working, he's going to have a hard time. Oh, he's he slept his mill, so he's going to repopulate right now. He bought some wood. Yeah, he got no knights or gold for that. Yeah, he got gold, but Mali has the upper hand with knights. They're faster than pikes, so Denzero has to go back.
Yeah, that's really true. Interesting. Mali manages to destroy a lot of woodcutters that belong to Denzero. And now Mali is going for Denzero's keep. I think he's gonna bring down the walls. The first row of walls. We see that Denzero brought the horse archers over there. Yeah, it's interesting. It's interesting. So after a failed attack from Denzero, right now it's time for Mali to attack his opponent, and let's see if Denzero's attack is gonna succeed or not. Right now both sides are shooting one as another. Their horse archers are fighting their horse archers. And in the meantime, the knights are bringing down the walls. And Denzero is actually firing at the knights. But he cannot dig the moats. He cannot dig the moats. Therefore, he cannot advance inside Denzero's castle. We can see that Denzero is making more knights. He's making more knights, and he's gonna attack. I think. Okay, Mali is going back, and right now Denzero has time to rebuild his walls. So it's I'm very excited, guys. Nightmare, do I look excited? Do I sound excited?
Because yeah, you sound very excited.
Yes, I am excited. I don't get a chance to see such matches, especially in my tournament. And when such a match is happening in my tournament, I'm very happy. Very excited.
Yeah, he's getting a lot of orgasms right now.
Oh, go away. So right now it's time for Denzero to make an offensive, and Mali is staying inside his castle. They are not allowed to use catapults, therefore it's gonna be hard for them to bring down the enemy units. Mali does not have any knights, assassins, and that. I meant assassins.
Mali made a cathedral though, and a church, so he can make a lot of monks, so Denzero can't advance fast in his keep.
Yeah, basically monks are good against knights.
And assassins. Oh, Mali's making more knights. I saw some more stables being placed.
Oh. Interesting. This is gonna be interesting. Mali also turned on his woodcutters. And Denzero is doing the same. But Mali has more woodcutters left. I mean, Denzero didn't manage to destroy any woodcutters. But we see that Mali turned his workers back to the keep. He turned them into leathermen. Basically, Denzero wanted to go and block the other gate. He could destroy some woodcutters.
No, I don't think he wanted to block the gate.
He wanted. Then what did he wanted to do?
That's a small glitch. If you destroy the wall, that your knights just walk the other way around. If Mali is going to activate the moat hole, which is also a little strong on Crusader physic, if he makes a small gap somewhere on the upper corner of his keep and destroys a wall there and a moat where he, when Denzero can go in, he can't dig the moat, which is a very annoying bug. and I'm really a bug on my Astronaut Crusader physic that a lot of experts seem to use.
So Dan Zero brought more portable shields to protect his horse archers and Mali.
Yes, assassins. You're sending assassins to the gate of Mali.
Oh, interesting. So yeah, it's gonna be interesting. I cannot see the assassins, but if I use a church, maybe?
Yeah, they're next to the gate, like six of them.
Oh, okay, I see.
You are the fourth greatest lord.
Oh. Mali is building another gate. Yeah, he wants to get out of the castle. He cannot stay in the castle anymore. He has to get out. Mali does not have any assassins. Dan Zero has. Nightmare is allied with Dan Zero, so he can see.
No, he doesn't have much assassins. Just not. Yeah, he's going back because Mali has more knights. Even though Dan Zero made good things, the gardens that give him a very big boost in the army for knights, which is very overpowered.
I see.
It does decrease his economy though, which is bad. And he's going to have a weaker economy but a stronger army.
Yeah, basically, both players had the same amount of units few seconds back, but right now we see that Dan Zero is building a lot of leathermen. Therefore, it's gonna be. Well, why they are doing that, Nightmare?
Because if they got a lot of ladders, they're going to disband them and just put their taxes minus 24 and receive a lot of gold from taxes. Because at the moment, ladders count as units, not as population. So whenever they disband all their ladders, it turns back into population. So that means it also counts on the taxes.
Exactly. So right now we see that Mali has assassins that are destroying Dan Zero's woodcutters. So I would say that Mali is trying to increase his advantages this way. Harrison, the enemy.
Dan Zero is sending more assassins.
Okay,
he has some assassins next to his right gate. He's sending them probably to kill Mali's assassins and the woodcutters.
We're gonna see a clash of assassins over there. Yeah, basically, horse archers are fighting horse archers. We see that Dan Zero has good things, Mali does not. So basically, Dan Zero's army is better. I will remember you guys, Dan Zero is with the orange color and Mali is playing with the blue color, okay? We can see that Mali also sends more assassins and Dan Zero's assassins got on the wall, yes. And they are running from Dan, from Mali's assassins. They're doing some little kills there, they're killing some little cutters. Oh, we see that, what did Mali do there with his arm?
He compressed his shields and horse archers into like a small area, so it means he is more defensive with the shields. So then experts always aim at one spot in the horse archers and shields. So whenever he does that, there's only one spot to aim at. So it's always random what gets killed, a shield or a horse archer.
Nice.
It's something that Mali uses a lot. But then Zero does have his fear factor, which also increases the shield's strength a lot. And then Zero apparently taxed. He disbanded his leatherman and he started taxing.
Oh.
He's making more knights.
Is he?
Yep, he is.
Alright. Okay, Dan Zero deals damage to Mali's knights. You can see that. Because of the wall, they can barely aim at them, but they are aiming. Crossbowman would be suitable for this. type of combat. I mean, they deal a lot of damages. Are fire ballistas allowed in Warfare?
No, everything that can cause fire is not allowed. And since fire ballista already has the name fire ballista, it's definitely
yes,
not allowed.
Yes, but my point here is that shooting at the units won't burn.
Yeah, it's not allowed.
So we see that Dan Zero got his moat digged. And right now Mali is retreating. He dug the moat and now he's going back. I will save.
It's because Dan Zero has more units. More knights, I mean.
Saving.
Oh, okay. Both players' horse archers are shooting at their horse archers. Okay, right now Mali started to shoot at Dan Zero's knight. And I think Dan Zero is gonna lose his knight. Even if he has the fear factor, he lost his knight. Or not? No, no. That's kind of good. No, no. I was wrong. Okay, right now Dan Zero is sending all his horse archers to attack the knight. This way he can actually kill them. Okay. So basically, Mali is the one who lost this battle, not Dan Zero. Hey, this is getting more and more interesting. They are populating and repopulating and so forth, guys. You see here, Mali getting back his peasants. He turned them back into woodcutters. Yeah. Okay, Mali brought more knights, and right now Dan Zero is.
He again forget to buy wood. He keeps forgetting that his economy is not really efficient at the moment. While Mali's workers are working all the time. Yeah, Dan Zero still was a bit too hasty with making the fear factor, you know, because Mali's economy was a lot better, so he can spam knights all the time, while Dan Zero has to make a lot of leathermen first before he can get money again. Because his economy is just not good enough with the fear factor to just spam knights all the time.
Exactly, so when two expert players play, the fact that you win or lose stands in the very little details like fear factor, because in time this affects you. So basically, if right now players went for a Brad Eco, would have been better for them. Is that true, Nightmare?
Yeah, I like the Brad economy better.
Okay, we can see that Mali is doing quite a push here.
Mali is really paying attention. Yeah, he didn't pay attention.
Dan Zero is not allowing Mali to free with his horse archers. We can see that he dealt a lot of damage. He killed a lot of units. We can see that Mali is moving units and he's moving them fast. Nice. Mali, please, he runs away. We see that Mali brought some assassins into the battle. Yeah, Dan Zero wants some more time. But that was very interesting and very exciting, guys. Those knights are indeed strong. Oh, Dan Zero was not paying attention. We see Dan Zero bringing horse archers into the battle. Okay, he's gonna attack. He's gonna attack Mali because he now has support from the horse archers. So basically, it's working for him. Yeah, he's pushing the knights that belong to Mali. And he kills some assassins as well. Alright. What do we see right now, guys? What do we see right now? Okay, the gate is closed. Mali is gonna lose those knights. Okay. Very good. Very good. Alright. Right now, the balance has changed. Mali is in trouble. Not down zero anymore. Okay. Dan Zero goes back because he doesn't have enough portable shields. He's gonna build more, yes. He's making engineers. He's gonna build more portable shields. Okay. And now Mali gets the chance to breathe. And he is sending his units outside of his castle. While Dan Zero is sending his units inside his castle, Dan Zero won enough time to dig them out, and right now his defense has been increased. Mali has to do. How's it called? Mali has to do pikemen or any other units that are allowed to dig them out, and nightmare. Nightmare.
Yes.
You told me that units that can make fire happen are not allowed. Is that correct?
Yes.
They are using slaves, man.
Slaves are only allowed to dig modes because they're the cheapest one to buy to dig modes. It's not an offensive unit, you know. A slave could never kill a knight, for example, but where a fire ballista could easily kill a knight. That's a bit difference between no fire.
Yeah, the difference is rules.
The difference is slaves.
I do not agree. As long as you don't set fire, you. No, I do not agree with this. No ballistas.
Well, even if ballistas are allowed, I don't think a lot of players will use them. Because,
I would
like,
use them.
Crossbowmen are also allowed, but nobody hardly uses them. Like, then Zero could easily build a tower and play some crossbows and Somali can't attack, but he didn't do that.
Why isn't he doing it?
Because most experts always like to use shields and horse archers because it's faster, you know?
Dan Zero loses some horse archers.
Sending some assassins?
Dan Zero?
Yeah.
Where are the assassins going?
He's sending them out of the gate now. It's a right gate. He's probably going to Mali's economy and stop him from repopulating.
Okay, I see. I see. We can see that Mali is building more portable shields. Or something else. Now portable shields.
Yeah, there are the assassins.
Let's see them. Where are them? Oh, I see them. We see that Mali has the assassins as well. You know what's curious? That Dan Zero didn't destroy any woodcutters that belonged to Mali.
He didn't get a chance to do it.
Oh.
That's kind of the point. Or he just didn't think of it.
Maybe he didn't. Maybe he's too busy with his.
Well, team. Now that Dan Zero did a very good play against Mali with those knights while he was unaware that Dan Zero was getting out of his castle while Mali was building shields, it was a very good play. So Mali is going to play a bit more safe now, I guess. Or is he just going to make the same mistake?
Alright,
Dan Zero is repopulating too. I guess he ran out of population from the ladders, so he got a lot of gold now, he got a big army, he got his fear factor working again. Yeah, I think this is going to be a long match.
Interesting. Myron, another player that is a part of this tournament, and he got to the final. He thinks, I mean, With this rule, Danzero has more chances to win.
I don't know. I think Myron is highly underestimating Mali. But Myron is one of those, you know, robotic experts, you know, always play the same. So I wouldn't really believe anything that Myron has to say, you know.
What is your relation with Myron?
Don't really like him.
Why?
He's a robot, and it's really fancy playing with robots. Got like the experts that play different, have variation in their playstyle. You just have robots that play the same every single game. It's just a bit boring, you know? Just don't like
it. If we found a perfect tactic, then why change it?
Because it's boring.
We see that Danzero is getting out of the cave. He's attacking. He's attacking Mali's unit, and we will see an offense from Danzero right now. Danzero is gonna bring down. Oh yeah, Danzero caught some units there. The gate. Also managed to kill some. Oh. Go for the knights! Go down.
Mali is taxing. Yep. I think it's over now, because if Mali got a very big army with lots of knights, there's hardly anything that Danzero can do about it. Especially because Mali is a very strong opponent with lots of horse archers.
Okay, I don't see the army that you're talking about.
What army? No, he doesn't have it yet, but he's taxing right now. Look at Mali's gold, it's going up very fast. So in small moments, he can also make a very big army. If he makes Fear Factor, like Danzero does, then it's just over for Danzero. Then Mali will win.
Okay, so we saw that Mali was in a tight situation. Some knights were attacking Danzero's horse archers, and Danzero's knights were not in the area to help him, therefore he had to run. We see that Danzero recruited some pikemen. Those pikemen will aid him to dig the moat. And now Nightmare was talking about a huge army of knights from Mali, but I still don't see it.
Yeah, he's making stables. If you look closely at your side of the hill, you can see Mali built a lot of stables more. With a lot more stables. Ugh, perfect English.
I seriously don't see that.
No?
Only see few stables.
Yeah, Mali's
built. He doubled the amount of stables that he built last time.
Yep. Oh, Mali is light. Yep, there they are.
Okay,
Danzero is also currently destroying Mali's woodcutters.
I see that. Oh, finally. Nice. We got that going. It's gonna be interesting. In the previous match when they played together, one against each other, they barely...
Yeah, Mali made good things, yep. Mali made good things. It's going to be a very hard match for Danzero now. And a lot more horse archers. Yep, it's going to be very hard for Danzero now.
Mali made bad things. Yeah, good things.
Good things, not bad things.
So yeah, the score is even right now. And Mali's getting more defensive points from those good things.
Yep.
Gonna be interesting. Maybe Mali is actually attempting something. Mali is building traps.
Danzero is making more ladders again. He's sending assassins.
How many assassins?
Ooh, I'd say like 20.
Oh.
Yeah, something like 20, 30.
So we see
that there's one little problem now, because in the first attack, Danzero could make a lot of ladders because his army wasn't very big. But now that both opponents got a very big army, it's going to be hard to make more ladders, you know, because they'll reach their max. And if I'm correct, the max in a 1v1 of the max with four players is like 700, 600, was it? So then Zero can't spam again with ladders unless he disbands his army.
Their population is increasing while they're fighting and still fighting. Okay, Danzio is sending his knights. He didn't fall in any traps so far.
Mali made a lot of traps. Oh, I see.
Exactly. Then Danzio also brought his assassins with him. Okay, okay. Yes.
No, I think Mali will win this. Yeah, Mali is a lot more nice.
Oh my god, that was a huge mistake.
Yeah.
Danzio made a huge mistake over there. Oh, we see that Danzio still has several knights. And I think Danzio managed to sneak Mali's economy.
Nah, he's just inside the economy, did not manage to sneak in. Nah, he's going for the population right now.
Oh, he's going out of there. Mm-hmm. So yeah, this will give Danzio more time to remake his army.
Yep, Danzio is taxing again.
Okay, interesting. Interesting.
Danzio has no assassins left in Mali's area. Nope, I don't see any assassins. So Mali just killed them all, which is good, because you don't want your economy getting sneaked.
Exactly. So we see Mali doing another attack right now. Mali is going to attack Danzio again. Danzio is very wounded from the previous battle, and the gold he has is very low. He's very low.
Yeah, but it's going up since he's taxing, and he guessed he has no gold because he just bought swords for more knights.
I see. You see how fast the gold goes up? This is happening because of taxes.
Yep.
Okay, Danzio is gonna dig them out, and I think, Mali is gonna dig them out. He brings some pikemen into the action. And I think Mali has chances to win right now.
Mali has the upper hand at the moment. Just Mali isn't taxing. He has a lot stronger, he has more fear factor points. Danzio has like 3, while Mali has the full 5 of them.
Yeah, he has 5. Okay, we see that Danzio is making lots of knights.
Yeah, Mali realized it, so he's going back. But Danzio is also losing a lot of horse archers since Mali's are stronger.
Alright, so we see that the battle continues. This match is taking longer and longer. More and more time.
Yep, that's a bit what Stormlords could say the expert matches are about, you know. They can take a lot of time.
Exactly, that's why it's good to save from now and then.
Saving.
We see that Mali and Danzio engaged again. And Mali pretty much seems to win this fight, yeah.
Yeah, it's because some of Danzio's knights got trapped in the gatehouse. Like I said, it's a very annoying physic for the gatehouse. As if an army is close, it just closes. It's very annoying. You can't control it even if you open it. It just closes out of nowhere. So Danzio got a lot of knights in the gate at the moment, if I'm correct or not. Is he going to open it? Doesn't open his gate, I'm sure.
Maybe he waits for Mali to get in and afterwards he's gonna open it. But we see that his knights are falling. I can hear them die.
Yeah.
He's bringing down the barracks in order to not allow.
Oh, yes.
Oh. Where are you going?
I don't know.
Yes, Danzio did a lot of damage. No, he's losing this. Danzio is losing this combat.
Yeah, Mali has lost a lot of shields. Because in a fight, shields always die first because they have the priority to that.
Yeah.
Miley should go back now and just play it a bit more safe, make more shields and just attack again. Because Dan Zero is weakened at the moment.
Okay, Dan Zero rebuilt his...
Miley is sending assassins.
Yeah, a lot of them. How did you see that?
What?
How did you see the assassins?
Because Dan Zeros are close by, so I get them visible too.
Okay, so. We see that... Miley is engaging. Oh.
You should play it safe. He's not playing safe.
Okay.
He's going for the horse archers.
Yeah, he did it. He did it.
Yep.
Now he's gonna go with the assassins and he's gonna do a lot of damage again.
Yep. Yeah, I think it's over pretty much. Horse archers are the most used units in this game, so they are very strong in an expert game. Since Dan Zero has no gold for more knights and no gold for horse archers, I think Miley got the upper hands right here.
Okay, we see that Miley is getting inside Dan Zero's.
Miley should shoot at the population of Dan Zero. Yep, he's shooting at the population. Very clever.
Dan Zero is protecting his population with portable shields. So we see that Miley is coming back. And he's bringing more knights and more assassins. Yeah, he's making a lot of assassins actually. So Miley has a bigger army right now. Dan Zero came with some knights from the side.
Yeah, Miley. I guess Miley won.
Dan Zero does not have anything right now.
Yep. Yep. They both realized that Miley won this game.
Yeah.
Well, I hope it was interesting for people to watch, to see a real expert game between two top 20 players that are very strong and know fire and flying stones. Maybe it's a bit one-sided that both just use like a couple units, like horse archers, shields. Not really much of a variation, but I think it's still very interesting.
And we can see that Dan Zero is not giving up. Dan Zero is actually fighting.
Yep.
And so, Dan Zero dies. This was it, guys. This was it. We can see that both players' economy was pretty much the same. They all have the same amount of gold, food, wood, stone, iron, weapons, population. Okay? They were very equal, okay? But at some point, your little mistakes are gonna cost you a lot. Or some random events like a gate closing out of nowhere. Well, this was it. I hope you enjoyed it. And see you in the final round when Miley will fight against Myron, okay?
Bye-bye.
Thank you very much for watching. Thank you, Nightmare, for being here with me.
Yep, it was a pleasure.
Bye.